So speak ye, and so do, as they that shall be judged by the law of liberty.
Listen, eternal life only comes from the Lord Jesus Christ. If you're not trusting in the Lord Jesus Christ for salvation, you are not saved. And the JWs do not believe that Jesus is God. And because of that, they are not Christian. They are not saved. They are yet in their sins. They have not received forgiveness of sins. And of course, we know that elsewhere it says that he thought it not robbery to be equal with God. You know, and hey, he had the same glory as the Father. And I want you to go to John chapter 1. Go to John chapter 1. In 1 John 2, it says, "Who is a liar? But he that denieth that Jesus is the Christ, he is Antichrist, that denieth the Father and the Son. Whosoever denieth the Son, the same hath not the Father, but he that acknowledgeth the Son hath the Father also." Well, the Jehovah's Witnesses claim to have Jehovah. They say, "We've got the Father," but guess what? They don't have the Son. They preach another Jesus, another gospel, and because they don't believe that Jesus is God, they are yet in their sins. Now, it's very interesting about Jehovah's Witnesses because this is a man-made organization, and their doctrines change over time as different men lead their organization. The Jehovah's Witnesses once taught that Jesus is God. But of course, they taught that he is God and Jehovah is God. And in their Bible, as most of you know, it says the Word was a God. And that was their stance for many years, that Jesus is a God and it's okay to worship that God and also Jehovah God. Well, they changed their mind on that. On JWFacts.com, it reads, Russell taught that we should worship Jesus and the initial Watchtower's charter specified that establishment of the Watchtower Society was to promote the worship of Jehovah and Jesus. So initially, the Watchtower Society, if you will, they taught worship Jehovah and Jesus. Yet since the 1950s, worshiping Jesus became regarded as wrongful idolatry. So back in the 1800s, they said, no, we're promoting Jesus and Jehovah, right? But what happens over time, you know, the truth comes out, what they really believe, and they just take Jesus away from the picture. Well, Russell, the founder, which by the way, he was connected to the Rosicrucians, the Freemasons. He came out of an Adventist movement. He supported Satanic Zionism. There's a lot of baggage that came with his doctrine where he came from, which would make sense why he has a problem with Jesus. But this article continues. It says, Russell promoted the worship of Jesus and prayer to him because he is our God. Their founder, Charles Taze Russell, taught that Jesus was their God, the God of the Jehovah's Witnesses. Now today, if you ask a JW, do you believe Jesus is God? They'll outright say, no, he is not God. There's only one God, and it's just Jehovah. There's a quote here that this comes directly from, this is from the Zion's Watchtower, printed in 1880. Listen to this. It says, it seems clear that his divinity was retained in humanity because he repeatedly spoke of himself as having come down from heaven, and because he, though passing through trial and sorrow as a man, was yet possessed of the authority and exercised the prerogatives of a God. Notice they say a God. 1880, they're calling him a God, not the God. That's where they go wrong to begin with, right? The prerogatives of a God. He was the object of unreproved worship even when he was a babe. Right? When they came to worship the babe, they didn't turn away the worship. Why? Because he is God. Well, we say because he is the God. They say, well, he's just a God, some other God, an additional God. The article continues, even the angels, delighted to do him honor when he bringeth the first begotten into the world, he saith, and let all the angels of God worship him. Citing Hebrews 1:6. He never reproved any one for acts of worship offered to himself, right? Jesus didn't turn anybody away that worshiped him. Why? Because he's God. He's the creator. Like I said, this is printed in 1880 in their Zion's Watchtower publication, the October edition, pages 2 and 3. What are they saying here? Jesus is a God, another God. He's some God, but of course they want to put Jehovah as a distinct God. Now around here, we don't believe in multiple gods. We believe in one God. And when Jesus and the Father and the Holy Spirit are one God. Well, they taught Jesus was a God to be worshipped, which is very interesting. Now you're in John 1. I want you to see this because their Bible, of course, changes this. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Notice it doesn't say the Word was a God. Jesus is who we're talking about here, and He was God. There's only one God. The Jehovah's Witnesses do not believe that. Verse 2, it says, the same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. There are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, the Holy Ghost. These three are one. And of course, as Christians, we understand that means one God. We believe in one God, the Father, the Word, the Holy Ghost. So when He says in John 1:1 that the Word was God, it couldn't be any clearer what we're talking about here. This is the Godhead. But yet Jehovah's Witnesses, Jesus, He's a God. He's a lesser God. Listen, there's a reason the JWs are part of a cult. They are wrong about who Jesus is. In this same chapter, look at verse 14. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld His glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. The Word was made flesh. That's saying God in flesh. The Word was God, and the Word was made flesh. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. Who? All things were made by who? Jesus. They don't believe that Jesus is the Creator. They think He is creation, which is to say, they don't believe that the Son has always existed. They believe that the Son was created by the Father, and therefore these three are not one, but there was one that created another one, and one God made another God, and it's okay to worship them all, they said at one time. Now they change that. Well, we can worship this one, but not that one. On JW.org, this is a quote. This is straight from their website. It says, God created Jesus before creating Adam. In fact, God created Jesus and then used Him to make everything else, including the angels. Now listen, that is another Jesus. When you go talking to a Jehovah's Witness and they say, yeah, I'm a Christian, we believe in Jesus too, they preach another Jesus. Not one that we've received, not one that we trust for redemption and forgiveness of sins. They've got another one, a strange God that does not line up with the Scriptures. Another Jesus, not the one that the fullness of the Godhead was in bodily. They have a different one. So again, reason number two is that the JWs believe Jesus is not the eternal creator. You know, they believe He Himself was created at some point in time. Yet Jesus created time. So how can you say that He was created before time or in time? You're in 1 Peter chapter 4. Look at verse number 16. Yet if any man suffer as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify God on this behalf. Now, this is the third mention of the word Christian, and I'm showing you through the Scriptures where the word Christian is used that the Jehovah's Witnesses are not Christians at all. So let's define it by the context. Take a step forward to verse number 19. Wherefore, let them that suffer according to the will of God commit the keeping of their souls to Him in well-doing as unto a faithful Creator. Listen, Jesus Christ created everything that's ever been created. And they teach that Jesus Himself is just part of the creation. He's just some point in time that God created. Well, you know, that's kind of contrary to the gospel. Jesus is the creator of heaven and earth. You know, He's not another creation. First, they say they believe Jesus was another God that was created in time. And then they said after He died, He only spiritually resurrected. He did not physically resurrect. What a strange God. What a weak God that they preach. And listen, it is another Jesus. This is not the Jesus of Christianity. Thank God that Jesus saved us. And you know what? He is a faithful creator. We ought to be faithful unto Him. But the Jehovah's Witnesses do not believe that He is that faithful creator. You know, they believe that He played a role in creation, but that not that He is the God of all, the creator of all. I want you to go to Colossians chapter 1. Colossians chapter 1. Listen, Jesus is the creator. He's not part of the creation. Jesus created time on day one. He is not bound in time or only exists in time. Jesus is the judge, the righteous judge of all souls, right? Jesus had the power while he was on earth to resurrect the dead. He had the power while on earth to forgive sins. Only God has that authority. Only God can do those things. And when they reject him, they reject their own forgiveness. They reject the God that made them and that can forgive them. So again, Jehovah's Witnesses are not Christians. And we see the Godhead taught right there in chapter 1 of Genesis. In the very beginning and through the very end, we see the same God all throughout. We see the Godhead, or what's often called the Trinity. We know the word's not in there, but these three are one. Hey, are we talking about one? What are we talking about? One God. Well, the Jehovah's Witnesses don't believe that. That's why they take it out. That's why they say he was a God. He's some other God.
So speak ye, and so do, as they that shall be judged by the law of liberty.